going. So in this chapter, verse 31, God the Father of our Lord Jesus, who is worthy of eternal praise, knows I am not lying. Why? He had a firm foundation of these three things. He only believed Jesus as Savior, and then he believed the Word of God is a true living God. There is no other source. That's why he had to go through many, many sufferings. Even, you know, the same Jews, they just whipped him 39 times. For how many times? In the book, on chapter 11. So, we must believe Jesus as Savior, and then we must believe the Word of God is a true living Word, and accept sufferings in your life for Jesus' sake. Then Matthew 5:12, for a great reward awaits you in heaven. Hallelujah. So that's how we guard ourselves. We can fight against evil power and false teachings. So we must come back to the Word of God and not only read, but it's about time to study in depth. Otherwise, we cannot grow. This is the only spiritual food God has allowed for us to have. You know, to see and hear and what we say in the world, that's not true. It's all bias. It's only just my opinion. But according to the Bible, what God says in the Bible, that's the only truth. That's why we must study in depth. We must have desire in our hearts to know, God, teach me. What does it mean? How can I apply in my life? How can I avoid these situations? It's inevitable. But I have no power, no knowledge, nothing. Help me. If you don't have a solid foundation, you cannot ask Him. That's our belief. In that way, even though Satan attacks every day, we can have a victorious life. See, for example, Jesus, after the 40 days of fasting, when He was in the wilderness, Satan came, test Him 3 times, nothing happened. God wants us to be like that. Whenever Satan attacks, go away. It's like a dust on my shoulder. You just stick. You cannot attack. I'm a child of God. I am a follower of Jesus Christ. I have a King of Kings, Lord of Lords in my life. There is no room for you to come in and distract and interfere my thoughts. I am filled with His Spirit. Go away. Because I believe Jesus is my Savior. I believe the Word of God is true. That's why He will bring me into the storm in my life. I have no fear. Because He will protect me. He will guide me. He will provide the things that I need. The most, He loves me, I know. He never leaves me, never forsakes. He's always with me. He's the only one who can save my life. The way I can go to heaven, anytime. Let's pray. Father God, we just thank You. As we looked at 1 Corinthians chapter 1, the problem was the division. But all the way to the 2 Corinthians, second letters, division, now it's a deceitfulness, false teachings. They claim themselves as super apostles. Father, we need to be aware of what is going on even within the church. If we don't fix our eyes onto Jesus, there is always a division. And wrong doctrines will come out to distract us. So Father, always help us to pray, to be in unity, and give us a heart, a desire to know who you are, and desire to read and to study the depth of the Word of God, to grow every day, the way Satan will no longer attack me, bother me. The way we can always have a victorious life to glorify you. I know that's the main purpose you planted NFC in this area. So Father, just give them your desire to know and to grow day by day, to be a leaders, mature Christians, to go out and be a salt and light to other people so that they might come to your kingdom. So Father, bless your children and bless this church. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
I'm the one who is born, and the answer.